Hello and welcome to another Revit Pure video. I am Nicolas Catelier, an architect, BIM specialist and founder of the website RevitPure.com. In today's video, we're going to be talking about the new release of Revit, Revit 2022. And this year, the context is quite special because in July 2020, last year, a group of architects, including Zaha Hadid, wrote a letter to Autodesk criticizing the slow development of Revit combined with the high costs. And honestly, they were right. It is true that the development of Revit in recent years seemed to have stalled, especially from the architecture point of view. A lot of features that deserve to be improved have stagnated. But this year, Autodesk clearly got the message and created the biggest release in a really long time. In this video, I'll be talking about my 10 favorite new features, but we've also created a special guide that explains 36 new features, and we ranked them from 1 to 5. The special guide has an 87 pages PDF and a full-length video tutorial. Check out the link in the description below, or go to revitpure.com/revit2022. Alright, let's get started with the features and improvements. Our favorite new feature in Revit 2022 is Phase Parameters in View Filters. This feature might seem unexciting, but it's a huge deal. Such a big deal that we made it the number one best new feature. In Revit 2021, the graphic override features are extremely limited. If I go to the Manage tab and to the Phases menu, and then to Graphic Overrides, you can see the overrides that are set to specific phases, Existed, Demolish, and New, for example. The problem is that you cannot distinguish between different categories. For example, all new walls, ceilings, floors will have the same override effects, which is annoying because on a lot of projects we would like to be a little more precise. A tool that could be useful for that is to use the view filters that I can reach by going to the filters menu here. If I click on Edit New and I modify one of the filters, the problem is that the phase created and phase demolished isn't present here. In Revit 2022 though, if you go to the View Filters menu by pressing VG, and I select the same category, now you can see that there's phase created and phase demolished. So, which means you can select a specific phase, either existing and new. The reason why it's such a big deal is that you mean you could specify specific categories of element for overrides. For example, I'm gonna go and pick the create a new filter first, which I'm gonna call demolished ceilings. I'm going to pick the ceilings category and I'm going to set the phase demolished equals new. That means that all ceilings that are demolished in new phase will be selected with this view filter. And here I add the filtered view. I had demolished ceiling. And in the pattern surface override, I can set a color, for example, red. So all demolished ceiling will have a solid fill pattern of red, but not the other categories of element though, that I could use different filters to customize. If I go to a reflected ceiling plan, you can view that the ceiling now has a solid red pattern, because it is set to the new phase for demolition. Another case where that might be helpful is if you have multiple phases in your project. Let's create an example where instead of having existing and new, we'll have different years for an historic project. So I'll just add a few years like this and give them the proper name. And the problem with the old version of Revit is that you were limited to graphic overrides here, which doesn't distinguish between the different phases, it is just new, demolished, and existing. So there's no way to actually set graphic overrides to specific year or specific phases of the project. With the new addition to phase created and phase demolished in view filters, let's say I come back here, I click on Edit New, and I create a new filter that, let's say I call it 1935, and I will select all major elements, let's say wall and windows. That should be good for a moment. and I will select face created equals, and I'll pick the first one, 1935. And I will add this view filter to this view, and I will set a cut pattern that is going to be, let's put green here, a green solid fill for this specific here. So if I go to this view and I select these walls and I switch them to face created 1935, you can see that they turn green like this. So this is a big deal. I've had multiple projects where there were different faces like this. So there's a big question if this graphic overrides menu will keep being used at all. I think it will for smaller projects, but on big projects where you require more customization when it comes to phases, I think that the view filter menu here will be really helpful, especially when combined with view templates. The number two best new feature in Revit 2022 is split schedules across sheets. In Revit 2021, the only thing you could do to split schedules was to click the small button here, which would split the schedule but on the same sheet. And then by dragging the blue dots here, you could adjust and you could move around the other schedule and you could merge them, but that's it. In Revit 2022, you have this new split and place button here in this big schedule. I'm going to click it. This menu appears and it asks me to pick between sheets. So I'll be selecting two sheets here and then I have this option, height on sheet. I will use split evenly for the moment. And I will be asked to place a schedule on the first sheet selected, but not on the second one. If I go to the second one where the other sheet is placed, the second half of the schedule would be placed on the exact same placement as the first sheet. And then if I go to the first sheet, I can adjust the blue dots here like this. And if I go back to the other sheet, the length will be adjusted accordingly. But on the second sheet, I cannot modify the height. It only can be done on the first sheet. If you have a look at the project browser, you can see that our schedule has been split into parent and children, and with the name 1 out of 2 and 2 and 2 here for the two segments. But if you enter any of these schedules, you'll still see the full thing. And it is possible to place the entire schedule in a sheet, or you can also place the small segments. It's up to you. However, once it is placed, you don't have access to the split and place button anymore. If you want to split into multiple segments, like add a third segment instead of just two, you have to delete the children and start all over again. The third feature is called Tapered Walls. Last year, Revit introduced a new feature called Slanted Walls. By selecting the wall and changing the cross-section to slanted and putting an angle, you could make the entire wall slanted. But this year, I think Revit actually put out an helpful feature, which is Tapered Wall instead. With Tapered Wall, instead of having the entire wall being sloped, you can select which side will be. So to activate the effect, let's click on Edit Type. And you will find the cross-section properties here. The first thing I want to do is go to the structure menu. And I need to set a variable material. You can see that this one is already variable, which is the air layer. I'm going to make this much thicker. I'm going to set it at 300, like this. And then I'm going to set a default exterior angle. Let's try 5 degrees for the moment. You can see that I now have 5 degrees on the exterior side, and I could also add an angle on the interior side, like this. So I would have 10 degrees in the interior and 5 degrees on the exterior. When the width measured at parameter is set on top, it means that the normal width of a wall, which is 589, will be measured at the top. But I could switch this and use bottom instead. Click on Apply. We get a warning because the wall is too tall. The angles will create a negative value for the air layer. Let's make the wall a little smaller. And now I should be able to switch it to bottom. Yes, you see what happens. The first time it didn't work because that would have been too small on top. And something to know is if I switch from positive angle to negative angle instead, and I click on apply, you can see that the wall angle goes to the exterior side instead of the interior. Now we've set this cross-section properties for the type instance parameter, which mean that all wall of this category of this type will be modified by this action. Something else that you can do is to activate the override type properties here. And now you can set specific angle only for this wall instance, like this. And you could also drag the blue dots like this to adjust the wall taper in a more intuitive manner. And you can also set the angle directly here. In old versions of Revit, you didn't have access to native PDF exportation tools. You always had to either use a paid PDF printer or a free one you could find online. So you often had to rely on printers such as PDF 24, for example. So nothing against this printer, but who wants to have this kind of weird pop-up every time you print, right? In Revit 2022, you will find the Export PDF tool. Go to File, Export, and PDF right here. So you will see this menu is similar to the print tools, but also a little different. The first thing you can do is to click on Selected Views in Sheet to print multiple sheets at once, and click on the pencil icon to modify the set of sheets. I'm going to click on Hide Unchecked Views in Sheet here, and now I can pick individual and specific sheets instead. I can then save my set by clicking the Save button. Another really helpful feature is on the size menu here. On page size, you can use the Use Sheet Size, which will automatically find the sheet size and use it when printing to PDF. Something exciting about this feature is that you can have different sheet formats, like 11 by 17 and 24 by 36 in the same PDF file. By default, you would see this combined selected views and sheets into a single PDF file, which is probably what you're going to be using most of the time, but if you uncheck it, you will get access to this tool here, which will allow you to customize the name of the PDF. For example, you can add the sheet name, the sheet number. When exporting to PDF, Revit will use these settings to generate names. Finally, I would recommend that you use a keyboard shortcut for this Export to PDF tool. So if you press KS, you will see the keyboard shortcut menu pop up and search for PDF. You can see the PDF tool here, and this is the shortcut I've already added. I've used XP to export PDF, of course, because this tool is going to be used very often. Do you have multiple elements of the same type next to one another? In Revit 2021, you had to create separate tags, just like this. There was no way to combine the tags together. Let's switch to Revit 2022. Now you can set a tag and click on the Add and Remove Host, just like this, and start to click on multiple walls. This is considered as a single tag, but with multiple letters. If you try to tag a parameter that has different values on multiple hosts, varies will get displayed on your tag, just like this. If you're enjoying this video, you will love our special pamphlet edition about Revit 2022. It contains tips and strategies to help you integrate the new features in your workflow and template. The special pamphlet is an 87 pages PDF guide that classifies all the 36 new features and improvements from most helpful to least helpful. Revit Pure pamphlets have been downloaded by thousands of users. Get your copy at revitpure.com/revit2022, and you will also unlock the full-length video tutorial about the new Revit, which contains every single new feature in the new version. Download the special pamphlet and video at revitpure.com/revit2022. Feature number 6 is shared parameters in key schedules. First, it's important to give some context. Some of you might have no idea what key schedules are all about. They are used to control multiple elements' parameter values at once by assigning them a key. Let's try to create an example of a key schedule by using the Rooms category. Let's go to the View tab, create a new schedule. We'll select Rooms, but instead of scheduling building components, we're gonna activate the schedule keys instead. And now Revit will ask to bring in a few parameters. We'll bring in floor finish, base finish, and wall finish, and click on OK. First thing that you can see is that there's no rows. We're going to create a data row by clicking here. I'm gonna click a couple of times, and then I can change the key name. The first one, just for the example, I'm gonna call dry rooms, and the second one is gonna be called wet rooms. And then I can specify the floor base and wall finish like this. So I'm going to quickly fill this up. Once it has been done, the first thing you'll notice is if you select a room, you will see the room style parameter. This is the key that I've just created. And you can assign either dry room or wet rooms to this instance parameter here. And you will see that the base finish, wall finish, and floor finish will be automatically filled. And you cannot change the value because it is assigned to a key. I have now created a regular room schedules with the room style key parameter. Let's zoom in a little bit. You can see that only one has a style for the moment. But if I start to add styles, you can see that base finish is automatically modified. And I cannot individually modify this base finish because it is set to this key. And if I want to modify the base, I would have to go back to the key schedule here and change the value right here. That means that the key schedule is used internally to control data. It is possible to create multiple key schedule. I'm going to go back to the View tab and create a new one, but also for the rooms. And this one, I'm going to call it the key name. I'm going to call it key occupancy. And I'm going to select occupancy and department. And again, I have to insert data rows like this. And the occupancy, I will call this one boss, and this one employees. Then I could return to my main schedule and add the new key to the schedule, which is key occupancy. And I could add these information. And again, I could add a specific key for each room, and this information would automatically be filled out. Just to be clear, everything I'm showing here is already available in the old versions of Revit. What is new is the ability to use shared parameters in key schedules. For example, if I go back to one of my key schedule, I'm going to add these two values, which are shared parameters that I've created, and I'm going to add them to this key name. And now I can type in whatever I want here. Well, I guess this might be an integer value. And if I go back to a plan view and select it, you can see that this number is automatically filled out by the key value that I've set in the schedule. Multi-category schedules now show system families like walls, ceiling, roofs, and floors. In fact, you can add all of these categories in multi-category schedules. To use the feature, go to the View tab, click on Schedule, and create a new schedule by clicking here. Use the first option, multi-category. You'll see a new field here, which is called category. Let's add it. Let's also add family and type, and click on OK. Basically, this schedule contains almost everything in your project. It is a great way for BIM manager to control what's going on in a model. In the old versions of Revit, it is impossible to select multiple view filters at once, either by using Ctrl or Shift. It just doesn't work. In the new 2022 version, it is now possible to select multiple view filters at once, just like this, which makes it much easier to set graphic overrides. For example, I could set the same graphic overrides for these three view filters. Let's set the background pattern just like this, for example. And let's set the halftone setting. So you can see that the visual setting is set for all of these filters at once. It is also possible to select multiple filters to move them up and down. Remember that the view filters on the top have priority over those at the bottom. Feature number 9 is revisions numbering flexibility. In Revit 2021, revisions numbering can be customized, but options are limited. Let's go to the revisions menu. As you can see in the numbering, you can switch between numeric and alphanumeric, but that's it. You don't have any other options than these two. In Revit 2022, you can create your own numbering system by clicking here. I'm going to click on this icon here to create a new sequence, which are called RP. You can use numeric or alphanumeric. I'll pick the first option. I can set a prefix. I can have a minimum number of digits. I can set a starting number like this. So I've created a new numbering sequence. Let's add a few revisions. And now I can switch the numbering. Let's say a couple of ones I add the RP numbering system. A few ones I might use the numeric, and for some other ones, I'll use alphanumeric. This allows you for much more customization of the way you use revision sequence. This new revision numbering system is compliant with the BIM ISO standards. Feature number 10 is improved parameter type filtering and search. If you create a schedule in Revit 2022, you will see all these new fields here. The first is parameter name search. You can type in the parameter to find it more easily. Also, you can click on this little arrow to uncover new filtering tools. You can, for example, specify parameter type, either built-in parameter, project parameter, shared parameter. You can type in value type here. So these are all the multiple types of values you can use in Revit. There's a lot of them. You can filter by discipline. And you can set for either type or instance parameter. An appreciated new addition is the available fields that is written just over here.